Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, she'akol nieh bidvaro. You know, there are a few themes that keep on popping up. One of them, of course, is anti-Semitism. But I'm not going to talk about anti-Semitism. I'm just going to say that one of the reasons for its persistence, why is it still here after thousands of years? Why doesn't it disappear? One of the theories is that man, society, need a scapegoat. You know, we have psychological mechanisms that make it very difficult to face up to our own shortcomings. So we always look for some kind of excuse. We look for an external reason. Why is it that we behave the way we do? So one of them is, you know, why am I not fulfilling my role in this world? Why don't I behave the way I should? Well, because there are Jews in this world, and they are at fault for whatever happens. Well, unfortunately, that is so. As a matter of fact, that is used by Israel and the Palestinians. You know, the Arab world uses Israel as a scapegoat, as an excuse for many of their shortcomings. You saw it in the Arab Spring. It has nothing to do with Israel, but yet it is used constantly. Even the United Nations. You know, the United Nations has a commissioner for refugees, and its name is UNHCR. They employ, I think, about 3,000 people. So what is the purpose of this commissioner? He has to place these people in different countries, in different continents, to solve the problem of refugees. Why is there a refugee? There are many reasons. There's war, there's hunger, there is political persecution, God knows why. So about 3,000 employees working in this commission in order to solve refugee problems in the world. But when it came to the issue of Israel and the Palestinians, there was a special commissioner instituted for that, that deals only with the Palestinian problem, and they employ about 30,000 people, 10 times as many as the others. For the rest of the world, 3,000 is enough. For the Palestinians, you need 30,000. What is their purpose? Their purpose isn't to look where to place these people in different countries. No, you maintain them in camps, organized with all sorts of services. You feed them, you give them some kind of stipend. You maintain alive the situation. You know, scapegoating, unfortunately, seems to be human necessity. We have to be able to blame somebody else because we cannot face our own shortcomings, our frailty, that we disobey the law, so we usually say something else. The student says, the exam was too difficult. The teacher isn't fair. He doesn't grade according to the papers that you hand in, but if he likes you, he gives you a better grade. All sorts of excuses. The employee says, well, the office manager doesn't like me. He doesn't say that he comes in late, that he doesn't produce what he has to do, that he can better himself. We always look for an outside cause for our shortcoming. Who invented this business of scapegoating? I really don't know. But you know, in the Torah, you find it. On Yom Kippur, the high priest would offer, in addition to many other things, two goats. One of them was called Seir Lazazel, was sent into the desert, thrown off a cliff, and he supposedly would carry upon himself all the iniquities, all the faults, all the sins of the Jewish people. And they were pardoned through this sacrifice. So we shouldn't be blaming anybody else because we invented it. It's in the Bible, in the Jewish Bible. There is a scapegoat, Seir La'azazel, it's called in Hebrew. But when you look at the Bible, you see something altogether different. Every sacrifice had to have with it teshuvah. You had to go through a process of introspection. It wasn't enough just to offer a sacrifice. You had to recognize what your shortcomings were. You had to resolve you're not going to repeat them in the future. The sacrifice was symbolic. It is something spiritual between man and God. But in order for it to be effective, there must be repentance before it. You must look into yourself. You know, the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed in the year 70. So our rabbis say, why was the Beit HaMikdash destroyed? You know who destroyed it? The Romans. Why was it destroyed? Our rabbis say something altogether different. You know why? Because of Sinat Chinam. We hated each other without any reason. Because we weren't friendly one to another. And also we weren't united. That was the reason that we were destroyed. Not because of the enemy. Maybe the enemy was used by God in order to show us a lesson. And why were the Romans used? Because maybe they were very cruel. That's why they were used. In other words, the Romans are not innocent either. But the main reason why it was destroyed, according to Jewish thinking, was our own weakness, our own shortcomings. So even though we invented the idea of a scapegoat, our idea of a scapegoat is only symbolic. We have to look first into ourselves. We have to better ourselves. And if you don't do it, no scapegoat will ever solve your problem. The scapegoat was effective only after the process of introspection, after the resolution of making changes in our own behavior so that we should be different human beings. So stop thinking, you know, if you're a student, you know, why you're getting bad grades, because the teacher is very unfair. Maybe you're not studying hard enough. Maybe you don't concentrate. Maybe you utilize your time in an inappropriate way. Think about yourself, what you can do. If you're not advancing in your office position, think about yourself. Are you friendly with other people? Are you ready to listen to new ideas? Are you reading constantly? Are you trying to improve yourself? Don't blame outside factors, because those that blame society remain in the same place. But those that look into themselves are those that advance in the future.